Very good morning, dear students. Hope you are well. Stay home, stay safe. Once again, I am reminding you, please be safe and utilize the time properly. Now, welcome back to the session. Yeah, now today we deal with the oscillations, the chapter oscillations. Yeah. Now, yeah. The chapter oscillations, in these oscillations we will study about actually the weightage point of view. You have long answers in this chapter. Okay. In this weightage, just we will weightage point of view, according to the weightage we will discuss. Okay, once you know the basic points and these three answers, which are 8 marks questions which are given in textbook, and that covers the three answers covers every point in the lesson. Okay, now I will also deal in the point of whatever the basic introduction as well as the question point of view. Okay, yeah, get ready, step back. Okay, so the long answers questions are: first question, define simple harmonic motion, show that the motion of a projection of a particle performing uniform circular motion on any diameter is simple harmonic. Okay, yeah, now we will deal answer with the basic points of our introduction. We will deal the answer. Actually, first of all, already we have discussed in the last class, the motion is of actually, that is a body. If a body change its position with respect to surroundings and a time, then the body is said to be in motion. Okay, actually we have studied the types of motion, which is a translatory motion. Yeah, translatory motion, again we have studied, yeah, rotatory motion, that is the reason I am just forwarding slides. Now, coming to the point, oscillatory motion. Okay, now we are going to see the type, that is a new type of oscillatory motion, which already we have discussed, is that the to and fro motion, that is a to and fro means back and forth of a motion of a particle along the same path as well as at a fixed point, about a fixed point. Let us suppose that the loaded spring like this. See, this is the fixed point. This is the fixed point. The spring is moving. Is it right? That is making to and fro motion, which is actually the oscillatory motion. It is making about a fixed point. It is making oscillations, right? Yeah. Now, so examples, see, this is also one of the best example for the oscillatory motion. See, this is a pendulum clock. These are the oscillations about a fixed point. This is a fixed point and this is making oscillations, which is known as oscillatory motion. Okay, yeah. Now, oscillatory, what is actually we have to show in our question answer point of view, what we have to explain? The simple harmonic motion is a periodic motion we have to prove. So what is periodic motion? In the last class we have discussed already, the periodic motion means a motion which repeats itself after a regular interval of time, means in each stipulated interval of time when it repeats the same movement, that is actually the periodic motion. Okay, yeah. So periodic motion, example, the I said already, the example motion of the earth around the sun, see, movement of the earth. Yes, this is the periodic motion. Just can you imagine only this part? Only this part. Half, first half, down half, you can imagine. Then what you can observe? Body is going, coming. So nothing but actually, simply by observing, we can say that it is simple harmonic only. That is to and fro motion we are observing at a section of the arc of the periodic session. Okay, now I will show mathematically. Okay, we will discuss. Every oscillatory motion must be periodic, but every periodic motion need not to be oscillatory. Okay, each regular interval of time, so whenever each regular interval of time means the linear motion, let us suppose that linear motion. So for first interval, it is covering 2 kilometers. In the next interval, it is covering 4. Next interval, it is covering 6. Means entire 2, 2, 2, 2. In equal time interval, it is possessing same. But it is not oscillatory. Remember, that is the reason I wrote here every oscillatory motion must be periodic, but every periodic motion need not to be oscillatory. Fine? Yeah. Now, the simple harmonic motion, now we will define. Okay, the harmonic motion, the motion of a particle which is repeated in position in the phase after a certain interval of time is defined as harmonic motion. Harmonicity means what? Harmonicity means a particle which is repeating same phase. That is harmonicity. Okay, yeah. Motion of the, that is examples. Harmonic motion example, motion of the minute hand of a clock, motion of the planet around the sun, a revolution of electrons around the nucleus. Yeah, give an example. Yes, the mouse is waiting. The rhythmic beat of heart, the heartbeat is also harmonic motion. Vibrations of a violin string, so string producing musical notes. All these are the example for the harmonic motion. Okay, yeah. Now, simple harmonic motion. Why I am abbreviating this simple harmonic motion? That is, simple harmonic motion means actually it is a form of an oscillatory motion. We are taking just a phase, means in a one of the instant level. That is the reason we are adding simple. Okay, the condition of simple harmonic motion, while we are saying simple harmonic, we are adding the condition is that the magnitude of a force is directly proportional to the distance of the body from a fixed point. This is the main point where you have to mention. Once you mention this point in simple harmonic motion, you, that is, you are proved that you have some concept regarding simple harmonic motion. Okay, and the next point is that the direction of a force is always towards the fixed point. Just now we have, in a previous slide, we have studied, that is a pendulum clock. A pendulum clock, the direction, think, where is the direction? Like it is moving, means towards the fixed point. Okay, yeah. Now, simple harmonic motion can be classified as, again, simple harmonic motion, see. This is a linear SHM. Linear means it is making linear oscillations. Means about a fixed point, it is making oscillations. That is along the straight line path, linear means. Now, come to second session, that is angular SHM. Angular SHM means, see, it is making, means here, the change is angular displacement. Whatever we have discussed angularly in the last class, that is along the curved path means that is angular SHM. Along the linear path is known as linear SHM. Okay, yeah. Now, linear SHM, just concentrate here. Linear SHM, this is a block. Let us suppose that these are the mass of a block M is fixed to the string here, spring. Okay, now this is called equilibrium position. I am just explaining equilibrium or rest. Okay, that is a mean position. It is at mean position. It is making to fro motion. Okay, yeah, observe. This is the mean position. That is the midsection. The spring is not stretched. The black dotted, whatever I given, the black dotted lines shows the equilibrium position of the block. Okay. Now, about that equilibrium position, it is making oscillations. See, in previous slide, we have observed here the black line. About the black line, here it is making oscillations, right? This is the linear SHM, okay? Yeah, now, when the block is pulled with a force of a string is stretched, right? Yeah, the block start oscillating. So it performs linear, simple, harmonic motion, right? Yes, make the concept very clear. Okay, once you are equipped with the concept, you can answer any question. Okay, equilibrium position. Okay, so now if there is no displacement at equilibrium position, actually no displacement. Why? Because it is a fixed point. Whenever it is making to and fro, then only it is supposed with some displacement. Yeah, sir, that is, there is no restoring force. Okay, So restoring force means whatever the force we are giving, it is not restoring. Actually, we didn't apply force in a firm case. Okay. So now I am applying force. When we pull the block towards right, means then you are applying the force. Okay. When you are applying the force, then see, it is coming towards the extreme position. Okay. So then, actually, after coming to this extreme position, the block has to be retained at equilibrium position. Right? That is our imagination. But here, what is going on? Here, this is, let us suppose that x, that is plus a displacement towards right. And let us suppose that x is at a positive direction. Now, see, whenever you are leaving that mass, whenever leaving that mass, what is happening? The restoring force act towards left. Why? Because it has to be reached at equilibrium position only. But beyond our imagination, whatever the force we have supplied to that block, it is utilizing to move backward again. That is actually the restoring force is responsible for that. Okay. Yeah, see, whenever you are leaving that block, then it is going, when we pull the block towards the left, let us suppose that if you are not only the right side, but also whenever you are taking extreme position of a left, then it will be minus kx, that is whatever we called, x is minus a we are taking, okay, in the negative direction, okay, restoring force acting towards right now, okay. The magnitude of a restoring force acting on a particle which is directly proportional to the displacement of the particle at a mean position. Okay. Yeah. The force is always directed towards mean position only. In previous slide, we have observed that the force is always towards equilibrium position, that is opposite to the linear displacement. Okay. So mathematically, the same concept we can write, the force is directly proportional to the displacement, that is F directly proportional to the X, where F is equal to, that is when we are equating, we are introducing the constant of Kx. Now we will speak about this Kx. Come up. Yeah. So K is the force constant of the simple harmonic motion. There the units, that is SI unit is the Newton per. That is, if you write K is equal to F by X, minus indicating what? Here the minus indicating the negative displacement. That is, from the mean position, it is in opposite direction. Okay. The restoring force is directly proportional to the displacement from mean position. Now, the complete definition point of view, the linear simple harmonic motion is defined as the linear periodic motion of a body, in which the restoring force or acceleration is always directed towards the mean position and its magnitude is directly proportional to the displacement from the mean position. This is the definition. Clear? Yes. Now, for linear SHM, this is the equilibrium position, extreme position, where the mean position, let us, at mean position, x is equal to 0, f is equal to 0. Okay, as we have discussed just now. See, it is moving now. Yeah, so right side to fro. So I'm abbreviating all here, whatever we are writing, x is equal to a, that is extreme position, x is equal to a, means what? The force, whatever you are asking, applying is f equal to ka. From the equation, f equal to k minus kx. Okay, now we are here to prove simple harmonic as a projection of that is uniform circular motion at any diameter. Simple harmonic motion is a uniform circular motion. We are proving at any diameter, means at any case. See, let us suppose that the projection I am drawing here. Just be careful. This is a circular motion. I am drawing a circle here. Yes, and I have drawn and a circle with x and y axis. Okay, I'm just observing. See, this is the center where this is the particle which is ready to move, that is oscillating. Let us suppose that with respect to y-axis, I am now studying. Yes, particle is moving. See, yeah, next projection, next state I am taking. Again, take next state. This is the next state. Again, consider again next state. Yes. Is it okay? Again, whenever you are taking C, the next state. Come to the next state. Yeah, next phase. State means what? Phase we are taking means uni. Is it a projection of uniform circular motion or not? I am checking. See, take negative side also. The projection I am taking negative side. Yes, is it clear? See, means what is going on? Yeah, I will just see. I just conclude the point. What we are observing means see. Projection of the body executing simple harmonic motion, right? Simple along the y-axis I am studying. Now you can study along the x-axis also, where the body is in the blue point, which I considered is a body in periodic motion, where the red is a particle, the projection of this region. Now in the second circle I am just observing with respect to x-axis. Come see. Yes, this is the next phase. Again, come to next phase. Yeah, come to next phase. Next phase. Yes, next immediate phase. Again, next phase. Yes. Along the x-axis, we are observing here. Right? All the points, I will make it clear. See, in a single note, the projection of a body which is executing simple harmonic motion, x-axis, we have observed just now. Now all the points which we have observed, I will make a note. See, that is, consider a particle performing uniform circular motion with an angular velocity omega. Let us suppose that along the circle of the radius, see, it is moving along the circle of a radius with that is angular velocity omega, right? Yeah. Now see, yeah, this is the distance. So called amplitude. I want to make it a term, amplitude. We will just soon after I will discuss with amplitude the term. Let the point O is the center, AB and CD are the diameters of the circle as shown in figure. Now, yeah, yes. Now let us suppose that this is the initial session. That is the initial point. Okay, at t equals 0. Suppose the particle starts from position P naught. Let us suppose that a particle is starting from here. Whatever we have observed earlier, I am just starting here the particle. Okay. Now let us suppose that that is the particle. Line. So that is angle DOP naught is, I am taking it as alpha. Yeah, I am writing. Yeah, alpha. Okay. Yeah. Now come to the particle in the next session of second. That will be. The reaches the position P. Again, I am taking here an angle which is a P. That is P naught O P. That is omega T, which is actually omega T means what actually? See, angle D O P. That is angle D O P is omega T plus alpha, right? Omega T plus alpha. See, what's actually theta actually here? Let us suppose that theta. Theta means by making arc length, we can write now. See, that is angular displacement is a theta arc length. In a previous class, we have studied about this. That is angular displacement, angular velocity is angular displacement by time. So angular displacement is theta, where time is t. Now theta equals omega t. So now, yeah, here I am writing omega t. Okay, yeah, omega t. Now it will give you omega t plus pi. Right? Yeah. Yeah. Expression for the displacement. And now I want to give expression for the displacement that is perpendicular to that is to determine. I want to draw a perpendicular here in this session. I want to draw a perpendicular. So from this perpendicular, I'm just noting down the point that is PM. I'm taking that is. Yeah, which is particle from the mean position, OM is a X. Okay, let us suppose that that is a displacement I am taking on a projection. Why? Because we are observing the projection. That is the reason I am drawing the projection for this particle. Where I am drawing normal and this is the projection, remember. Okay, so OD and see this OD and PM2. Actually lines are parallel lines and OP is intersecting them here, right? Yeah. Now, see, this is omega t plus. As two are actually the parallel lines here, the angle, that is omega t plus pi, whatever the angle is possessed by here, the same angle will be traced here. Okay, that is in triangle. Now I am here to derive an expression for the displacement in simple harmonic motion when a particle, the displacement of a particle which is in SHM. The sine omega t plus pi, sine omega t plus alpha, yeah, I'm writing for this triangle. The sine angle I am just projecting out, which is OM by OP, OM by OP for the sine angle. For this is the angle sine theta I am writing. Okay, yes, using that sine omega t plus alpha, that is x by a from that diagram, that is where x is equal to a sine omega t plus alpha. This is actually the expression for the displacement at any instant. Okay, expression for velocity, the same. Once you know the displacement, we can find the displacement very easily. Yes, quick. Yeah, make a session. The velocity of a particle is the rate of change of displacement with respect to time. Yes, I know all. Yeah, TRIANs actually done this with the velocity, right? Yes, I know. You boys and girls. Okay, so velocity dx by dt, where d by dt of a sine omega t plus. Now, whatever you have done on the paper, I am doing here. See, check, is it right or not? Am I right? So velocity is a omega cos omega t plus. Okay, this is an expression for the velocity of a particle which is performing simple harmonic motion. Now come to acceleration a. Once we know the displacement, we can find the velocity and we can find the acceleration too. Okay, so the acceleration of a particle is the rate of change of its velocity with respect to time. So acceleration is dv by dt, where that is d by dt of whatever we got here. See, a omega cos, that is we have determined already the velocity. So this is the term of velocity, that is a omega cos omega t plus pi. Now I am differentiating. The differentiating is d by dt, that is, see, differentiation, this is a omega left like that, and a cos omega t plus, for cos actually that is minus sign, so minus is here, minus sine omega t plus pi, again derivation to this term which is omega. So now a omega already was there, and a omega is added, that is a omega square sine omega t plus pi. This is the acceleration. Okay, where omega square, I'm writing minus a sine omega t plus alpha, is nothing but acceleration, that is, this is the displacement. So acceleration term I can write minus omega square x. Okay, yeah, so important terms in simple harmonic motion, which is the equilibrium position, extreme position, extreme, that is left extreme, right extreme. Okay, so displacement, whatever the terms we have to remember in simple harmonic motion. I will just move the slides fast. Just observe, the distance covered by a particle performing simple harmonic motion at any instant from its mean position is called displacement. Okay, that is SI unit. What is SI unit? That is a meter. CGS means a centimeter. Dimension means m power 0, l power 1. Remember, students, whenever you are writing any term in a physics, definitely you have to mention with the units and dimensions for it. That is the reason the very first and the second units you are studying about units and dimensions. Okay, yeah, now come to amplitude. In this, the maximum displacement of a particle performing simple harmonic motion from its mean position, the maximum displacement is known as amplitude. Okay, again, SI unit is meter, that is CGS unit is centimeter, dimension again same. Now come to path, range. Okay, that is a path length. Okay, Range means what? The distance between two extreme positions of a particle means here. How much the range here to here? Okay, that is the distance between two extreme positions of a particle performing simple harmonic motion is called, that is a range or path length. Okay, it is a distance equal to twice of the amplitude simply. Here to here maximum displacement is amplitude. No, this is one amplitude. Here to here maximum displacement is amplitude. And range means what? Here to, this is highest, that is a left extreme position, and this is the right extreme position. Okay, the distance between left extreme to right extreme, which is known as range. Okay, yeah, SI unit the same again, which represents the length only. Now period, which is the time period. Time period means the time taken by the particle performing simple harmonic motion to complete one oscillation is called time period, which is 2 pi by omega. Already we have discussed this. Come to frequency. The number of oscillations per particle performing simple harmonic motion in 1 second is frequency. That is n equal to 1 by t. 1 by t means again omega by 2 pi. Okay. So which is equal to hertz. Okay, now phase, we will find out the phase. Okay, phase means what? The total phase. Phase means what? The state of a point is phase. Okay, beta. Yeah, the total phase of a oscillating particle at any instant gives an idea about state of a particle with regards to its position and the direction of motion. Okay, suppose a simple harmonic motion is represented by an equation x equal to a sin omega t plus pi naught, then total phase, what we can say, that is phase is pi. Okay, and the total phase is omega t plus pi naught. Okay, pi means what? Omega t plus pi naught. Pi is the phase, omega means this term, whatever the term accumulated with that is, which is with the sine angle, that is angle, this is the phase. Okay, here pi naught is known as initial phase. Pi naught means starting position. Okay, yeah, it gives the initial phase means it gives an idea about position of oscillating particle at initial time, that is at t equal to 0. The initial phase is corresponding to different position of the particle, that is particle is at a mean position at t is equal to 0, x is equal to 0. Then like this we can substitute t equal, that is in a x equal, this is the equation, x equal to a sin omega t plus pi naught. Now I am substituting at t equal to 0, x is equal to 0. Substitute here, you can get initial phase is also 0. Okay, the particle right extreme means in all the points you can find out the phase like this. That is at t equal to 0, at x equal to a, bit point of view, very, very important. Find out the phase of a particle at t equal to 0, x equal to a, like that. Okay, yeah. Yes. In various cases, we can find that this is the phases at 0, at a by 2, at a, at minus a by 2, at minus a. You can find out the phases like this. Okay. Yes. Yeah. It can be known the concluded. Yes, this is we have proved actually. At t equal to 0, particle starts from mean position going to right side. Then x equal to a sine, that is a sine omega t. T equal to 0, if a particle start oscillating from extreme position going to left side, which is a sine a cos omega t, means limits. See, observe what we are observing. Oh, sorry. So what we are observing, within the limit of, that is a left side a cos omega t, the right side a sin omega t. So we are just within the phase of just 180 degrees, it is moving. So which is nothing but it is under uniform circular motion, maintaining the phase below 360 degrees. Okay, that is one of the proofs. Okay, now come to second question. Show that the motion of a simple pendulum is a simple harmonic, and hence derive an equation for its time period and what is a seconds pendulum. Okay, second question. Okay, simple pendulum. Again, come to simple pendulum. So an ideal simple pendulum means we know here. So an ideal simple pendulum is defined as a heavy particle, means a particle. Heavy means what? Heavy. Comparatively, this the thread. Okay, heavy means this. Heavy means don't imagine that is heavy. Suspended by a weightless, inextensible, and a twistless string from a perfectly rigid support and allowed to oscillate in a single vertical plane under gravity. Okay, so practically, simple pendulum is defined as a small heavy sphere that is suspended by a light and inextensible string from a rigid support. Practically, okay, heavy means don't imagine the big sphere. Okay, heavy means comparatively this thread, this is heavy. Okay, yeah, length of a simple pendulum. Length of a simple pendulum is defined as the distance between point of the suspension and the center of gravity of the sphere. So this is the length. So here, length like this. Here, from starting, that is the center of this, we are taking length. Okay? Yeah. The mass suspended is called bob of the pendulum. Whatever that is a bob. And yeah, to show that small oscillations of a bob execute linear simple harmonic motion, the assumptions we have to assume like that. That is, to discuss a simple harmonic motion, I am giving some assumptions. That is, the bob is small and heavy. Okay, the string is weightless and inextensible. The angular displacement theta of the pendulum is very small. Means whatever you are giving, whenever you are producing oscillations in a simple pendulum, you have to take away for only for below 5 degrees. Okay, don't pull completely 30-40 degrees. Just give small oscillations. So then only you can get accurate results. Okay, the length of the pendulum is large. The bob moves along the straight line. That is, the motion is linear, simple harmonic motion. Okay, so the support is to be fixed, which is rigid. Okay, and we are avoiding here air resistance. Okay, by making all those assumptions, keep in the mind, we will go for the simple pendulum concept. When the bob is at rest, the string is vertical. See, when the bob is at rest, the string is vertical. Where this is the bob, okay, this is the string, this is a fixed rigid point, this is a mass, the bob with mass, where this is a length, okay. This is the equilibrium position, as just we discussed in the spring case. Here, in case of simple pendulum, this is the equilibrium position. Now, see, I am pulling, come. Yeah, in this position, the weight, see, in this position, the weight is actually what is acting? That is MA, that is MG is acting here, gravitational force. Mass of the bob along with the gravitational force is acting. Okay, the bob is balanced by the tension in the string. Now, see, whenever, yeah, this is the tension acting in the string. Let the bob is displaced by small amount of x from the position, that is in a vertical plane. Yes, I am moving. See, yeah, moved. So whenever I am moving here, just imagine whatever the forces are acting on this, this is at mean position. I am taking displacement over here with a small angle theta. Now, see, with a small angle theta, the angle theta is made by a string with a vertical is very small. And at this position, forces acting on the bob are, see how many forces are acting? That is, rather than only mg, the mg, that is the force component, is resolving here. Okay, the resolving is nothing but it is weight is mg, no, vertically downwards, the resolving the components, which is actually, which creates the tension in the string. Okay, so we resolve mg into two components in such a way that mg cos theta, which is along the radius, mg sin theta, which is along the tangent. Okay, so that is the reason two types of forces we can resolve here. Where mg cos theta is utilizing in order to maintain the tension in the string, mg cos theta is utilizing. In the same way, whatever mg sin theta is acting here, that is towards the mean position, right? Towards the mean position means here what? It is acting means a restoring force, whatever we have discussed just now, no? So it is utilizing, the mg sin theta is utilizing to pull the ball again towards the, that is a pull the bob towards the mean position, right? Yes. Yeah, the radial component mg cos theta is balanced by the tension, while actually the tangential component mg sine theta is unbalanced. That is unbalanced means it is dominating. So due to that domination, it provides restoring force. Okay? Yeah. Now due to that restoring force, what happens? Resultant force and above will be F equal to minus mg sine theta. So using that, yeah, sine theta we are taking very small now. So that is the reason for small angles. We know that the fact is that for very small angles, sine theta is almost all equal to theta. Okay. So which is sine theta equal to arc by radius. Arc means there, that is a x. That is a displacement, no? Displacement by x, that is L. Since theta is very small and in the trigonometric case, I just considered. Okay. A restoring force, what we can write here, that is minus mg x by L. Yes? Clear? Minus mg by L into x, where k is mg by L is constant always. Okay. Yes, this shows that the force acting on the bob is Fr, that is a restoring force is equal to minus kx, which is directly proportional to the displacement from the mean position. It is directed towards mean position. Thus, both the conditions of simple harmonic are satisfied. Therefore, the motion of a bob of a simple pendulum is simple harmonic. Is it clear? Yes, expression for the time period of the pendulum, actually from Newton's second law, this is actually extension to that topic. Okay, so the Newton's second law, that is F equal to ma, we can write here. Acceleration, we know that F, restoring force by m. Okay, so Fr, just k, but this is a previous slide. Fr equal to minus mg by L into x. Now I am writing here mgx by ml clearly. Okay, now mm gets cancelled. Now it is A equal to minus gx by L. So A equal to minus omega square x, right? Yes, using these two, what we can write? See, omega square equal to g by L. Okay, omega, that is equal to root over g by L. T is equal to 2 pi by omega, where T equal to 2 pi root over L by g. See, time period of a simple pendulum very easily we have derived. Okay, this is the time period of simple pendulum. Now what we can conclude? The time period of a simple pendulum, it is accelerating. The special case, yeah, accelerating, special cases also we will discuss here. Acceleration, retardation, whenever retardation means whenever the negative acceleration. In case of negative acceleration, yeah, that is time period at 2.5. So we can horizontally also. If pendulum suspended from the roof of a vehicle, let us suppose that in a vehicle we are habituated to hang some idols, no, small idols. For that also, that is also making oscillatory motion. No, when that moves freely downward the plane with the inclination theta, then also we can find that is the net acceleration acting on it is that is root over g square plus g sine theta whole square 2g, like that we can write cos 90 plus theta. Okay, this is the extension to this topic. Okay, you can just make a note. Okay. Yeah, whenever pendulum is placed, this is the extension, no need. Yeah. Yeah, laws of a simple pendulum, very, very important. Law of length, you have to remember this, law of length. Tell me what T proportional to the time period of a simple pendulum is directly proportional to the square root of its length. So root over L. Okay, this is first law of length, law of acceleration. Okay, that is acceleration due to gravity. The period of simple pendulum is inversely proportional to the square root of g. That is, yeah, that is 1 by root over g. Now, law of mass. The period of simple pendulum does not depend on the mass. Okay, and the law of isochronism. Isochronism means here amplitude case. That is, isochronism means differentiation in the amplitude. The period of simple pendulum does not depend on its amplitude. Okay, yes, these 4 points you have to remember. Length of a seconds pendulum. See, seconds pendulum means what? Seconds pendulum means here the time period of a simple pendulum is 2 seconds. Okay, the simple pendulum which has 2 seconds of a time period, that is actually the seconds pendulum. Now, what will be the length of a seconds pendulum? T is equal to, see, 2 pi, actually time period is 2 pi root over L by G. This I am saying it is time period of simple pendulum is 2 seconds. Indirectly, I am saying seconds pendulum means what? It is 2. Okay, so equate for a seconds pendulum time equal to 2 seconds by definition. So here 2 is equal to 2 pi root over L by G. 2 gets cancelled. What you will get? Length. I am finding length now. So length is equal to what we can write? That is L is equal to G by pi square. Big point of view, very, very important. Length of a seconds pendulum is G over pi square. This is actually the second question answer. Okay, now move to third question, the final question. Now, derive the equation for kinetic energy and potential energy of a simple harmonic oscillator so that the total energy of a particle is a simple harmonic motion is constant. Okay, in a path at any point, energy is constant. We have to show that. Okay, now come to answer energy in a simple harmonic oscillator. Okay, yeah, energy of a simple harmonic oscillator, the mechanical energy associated with the particle which is executing simple harmonic motion at any point, actually the basic point, it is combination of potential energy and kinetic energy at that point. Okay, so expression for the kinetic energy, what expression? The both kinetic energy and potential energies of a particle in SHM vary between and their maximum values, of course. I will explain you this point again. Now, expression for the kinetic energy, the velocity of a particle executing simple harmonic motion is periodic. That is a periodic function of time. Okay, now come to expression for the kinetic energy. Yeah, the velocity. See, kinetic energy, we know that. What we know? Of mv square, we know. Okay, the velocity of the particle executing simple harmonic motion at any position is given by, this is actually the velocity we know. Okay, so v is equal to omega root over a square minus y square, where y is the displacement here. Okay, so the kinetic energy, how we can find? That is, kinetic energy equal to half mv square, half m omega square root over, that is a root gets cancelled, a square minus y square. Okay, so this is the kinetic energy, right? Okay, so we can write this also. Actually, v equal to, already we in previous slide we have derived velocity is equal to a omega cos omega t. This also we can write, no issue. Like this also, using that expression we can write half mv square means half m a square omega square cos square omega t. We can write, no, expression for the potential energy. Come to potential energy. Consider a particle of mass m executing simple harmonic motion. If the force is acting at a displacement, so then restoring force would be, what will be the restoring force? That is F equal to ma, that is minus m omega square y. Why? Because a, acceleration, we have derived acceleration, no, that is minus omega square y is acceleration. So ma, yeah, restoring force. So work done in displacing a body through a small displacement dy against the restoring force is given by, that is work done. I am calculating here work, potential energy means what? The storage of work done is nothing but the store in a body, whatever the energy stored for a movement, work done to displace, that is actually the potential energy. So in order to find the potential energy, we have to calculate indirectly work done. Okay, so that is work done equal to minus F dy, where that is m omega square dy. Okay, Now the total work done displacing, that is 0 to some displaced, 0 to some other point, that is 0 to y you are taking here, that is the small amount of work if it is dw, by making integration you can get entire work done here. Okay, this is the work done, that is m omega square, where y square make that is y, that is integral y dy. What is the formula? That is y power n plus 1 by n plus 1. So using that y square by 2, where the limits I am applying 0 to y, where half m omega square y square. Okay, this work done is stored in the form of potential energy. Wherever the mechanical system, remember boys, wherever the mechanical system, whenever you have to find out the potential energy acting on a system, you have to find out directly work done. Okay, so the work done is nothing but how much is the potential energy it is possessing, that's it. Okay, potential energy is equal to half m omega square y square, which is half m a square sine square omega t. Y is equal to a sine omega t. Y means what? Displacement. A sine omega t is y. Okay, now we derived kinetic energy and potential energy. Now we come to the point that is at positions, that is at extreme position, let us suppose that y equal to a. Okay, if y equal to a, what happens? Half m omega square y equal to a means what? Substituting a here. Okay, that is kinetic energy half m omega square a square minus y square. Okay, that is y equal to a means what? Zero. So, and what you are understanding here, at extreme position the particle is associated with only potential energy, there is no kinetic energy. Now come to total energy, is this what? How much is the total energy? Half m omega square a square only. Come to next session, that is at mean position I am calculating. Mean position means y is equal to zero. Okay, that is potential energy is half m omega square y square. How beautiful it is, no? See, kinetic energy half m means you are getting here at the mean position, you are getting potential energy is zero. At extreme position you are getting kinetic energy is zero. Hey, by the hence entirely at every point, see, whatever it may be the point, even it is a extreme position or in the mean position, total energy is same. Are you observing? This is the beauty. Okay, yes, beauty of nature here. The total energy, see, the total energy what you are observing, that is total energy is kinetic energy plus potential energy, which is half m omega square a square, right? Yeah, yet any position potential energy half, this is generally at any position potential energy is half omega square a square, kinetic energy is half omega square a square minus y square. So total energy, what happens? Make this total energy, you are getting this only, no? Half m omega square a square means what? At any position it possesses, from equation 1, 2, 3 it is clear that total energy of a particle under simple harmonic motion is constant at any of its point. Okay, kinetic energy, see, at mean position, mean position y is equal to 0, that is y equal to 0 case, half k a square. Okay, that is half k a square means what? A is amplitude, that is 2 pi square. Okay, m n square a square, where, yeah, 2 pi n, that is, okay, omega is 2 pi n, omega square equal to k by n. Using that you are writing here. An extreme position y is equal to plus r minus a, now k minimum. So average kinetic energy we can find, that is kinetic energy for minimum, maximum, that is average we are finding. So kinetic energy will be half of the maximum value at displacement y equal to a by root 2. Very, very important concept. Okay, if the frequency of a vibration is n, then frequency of a vibration of kinetic energy would be 2n, definitely. Okay. Yes, that is, see, average kinetic energy. I have determined average kinetic energy at a minimum position, this is zero. At maximum position, this is half m omega square a square. By means of that, we can get 1 by 4. Bit point of view, very, very last time MCET question, this is 1 by 4 m omega square a square. Okay, which is k a square by 4. At mean position, you have to determine all the positions like this at mean, extreme, average, potential energy also you can find. See, potential energy will get you maximum by 2. The potential energy half the maximum value at a displacement y is equal to a over root 2. Okay, if the frequency of a vibration is n, again then the frequency of vibration of potential energy is also 2n. Okay, total energy, see, total energy in SHM, yeah, energy, the conservation principle. Now we are observing in case of a simple pendulum. Okay, total energy is equal to kinetic energy plus potential energy. Expression for total energy is what? The ET, that is total energy is equal to kinetic energy plus potential energy. So I am making plus where you are getting already, we have just studied in previous slide, half m omega square a square. That is, this is total energy. Half k a square is total energy. Okay, where that is what? 2 pi, yeah. That is total energy where I am substituting 2 pi f. You can get that is frequency 1 by t. We can write in terms of, means we can define where actually how it is relating with other terms. Total energy is directly proportional to the square of the amplitude. Total energy, okay, directly proportional to its mass, inversely proportional to square of the time period. Clear? Now I want to show that is the cases at mean position, that is total energy in the mean position. Okay, the total energy mean position, this is ET equal to EK maximum. Mean position, EK is maximum. At extreme position, EP is maximum. Remember this. And I will show in a graphical note. Okay, see, this is x-axis and taking y-axis here. Now, I am taking on x-axis energy, on y-axis a displacement. Now, come to the point of this is the origin, and where x, that is origin means what here? X, that is equilibrium position. This is the right extreme position. This is the left extreme position. Okay, don't take positive, negative. Right extreme, left extreme. Now come to the session, and the total energy half k square, where I am just taking the boundaries. Yeah, within the boundaries, ET equal to half k square, and the total energy here also half k square. Yeah, wherever may be the point, the total energy is half k square only. Okay, yeah. Now, yeah. Now total energy I am taking here, see. EK, kinetic energy I am taking of k a square minus y square at y equals 0. Whatever the points we have derived just now, I am showing graphically. Be careful. Okay, and just you replay the slides, then you can understand the concept, dear students. Y is equal to 0, EK maximum, that is half k a square. See, the point I have taken, y equal to a, that is EK minimum. The point minimum is here, the maximum is here. Yeah, so see, this is the minimum, this is the maximum, the point. Yes, again the point here. See, these three points, that is a red color, these three nodes I have derived. So, what will be the curve here? Guess the curve. Yes, this is the curve. Whatever you are guessing, it is playing on the screen, right? Is it right? Yes. Now come to the session. Next, it is in what? Going in a higher side. This is the graph for the position of in a positive direction. Yeah, now come to next session. That is minimum session. That is at y equal to, that is a negative session, y equal to 0. EP minimum is 0. Means here this is 0. At y equal to a, EP maximum is half k square. So maximum is k square. Means here, this is the maximum. Half k square is where? Here only, no. So put the dot here. And now, see, this is. Okay, so the first positive displacement and the negative displacement, I have covered the graph. Is it clear, boys? This is actually the graphical note. Okay? Yeah. Till this slide, this discussion, you have to continue about the energy of oscillator, simple harmonic oscillator. And you are proving that every point, see, dots also, where are the dots? Whatever it may be the inner energy, See, dots, where are the dots? On same notation, no? Same note, you are observing the dots, no? Means what? What it is proving? It is showing that every point energy is same. Total energy is same. Whatever it may be, combination of potential energy, let us suppose that, and in order to conserve itself, it is taking, let us suppose that potential energy is minimum, then kinetic energy would be maximum. Okay? Okay. Yes. Okay. Now, yes, variation of kinetic energy, potential energy and total energy. Again, the displacement, we have energy in simple harmonic motion. See, I'm concluding this, that is conclusion, graph. Okay, so from the graph I'm concluding, at mean position, total energy is purely kinetic energy. At extreme position, total energy is purely potential energy. Okay, and the kinetic energy and the potential energy are interconvertible in middle points. Mean position, total energy is only, kinetic energy is only total. At extreme position, potential energy is total energy. And meanwhile, different, the middle points, the kinetic energy and the potential energy are convertible, interconvertible in order to conserve the energy in the system. Right? Is it clear? Yeah. The nature of a graph of kinetic energy and potential energy against the displacement, how was the shape? It was parabolic. Okay, again, the bit point of view, concept point of view, very, very important. Okay, is it clear? So, these are the three questions and answering session. So, I want to give an assignment to you, end of the session. Please, just write on a paper. All these answers, write on a paper and just check yourself and check with your concerned lecturers. Okay, so what you are giving, and whatever the information, in a less time period, you have to give more information. Okay. So, regarding whatever you know. Okay. So, winners. Who are the winners? Who are doing differently. Okay. So, who are you doing differently means what? You have to give how much is necessary. You have to give that much. Okay. But whatever you know regarding that, how much you can give, you have to give your efforts. Okay. Energy in the conservation. See how the energy is going. See, I'm showing you here. This is a linear spring. Here, angular ascension. How the energy is changing, I'm showing in a single slide. Just okay, like this, kinetic energy, potential energy. See how it is very kinetic energy variation, potential energy variation. Whatever it may be, the session total energy is the same again in a equal line, like the horizontal line it is showing. No, like this. Okay, yeah, this is about the simple harmonic motion, the oscillatory motion. Okay, this is the session where I would like to conclude. Okay, thank you very much. Thank you once again. Okay, once again, I am suggesting you, dear students, please utilize the time properly. Stay safe, stay home. Okay.